What do you make of the Georgia quarterback situation? Well, I think it's Jamie Newman's job. I think it's his party there. I don't necessarily know, and like I've talked about a number of times, I don't know what to make of it. That's your question. I don't know what to make of it, only because I don't know what style of football they're going to want to play there. I've gone over this quickly, just kind of a cheater's guide to the overall take that we've had on Georgia is, you know, Georgia goes through what they went through last year, and they were banged up defensively by the time they played LSU, but regardless of what the state of that program is, they got pasted by LSU, and they played good. That's what they know. I mean, they played good and still got flooded. They got drowned by LSU's offense to where, you know, I think Kirby Smart finally looked around and said, well, I can have the number one defense in the country. I got to play teams like this. And if it's not LSU, I'm going to have to play Alabama. Then if I get in the playoff, I got to play Clemson. I got to play Oklahoma, man. We got to be able to trade points. The best defenses he was ever a part of at Alabama, they didn't go through any seasons aside from the 2011 season where they just shut everyone down defensively. There was a game or two in there every time where they had to trade points with someone. They could have number one defense in the country and have to win 48-42 at Ole Miss one year. So you got to do that at Georgia too. And so you got to do a couple of things. Number one, you got to have the horses in the barn. They didn't have that from a personnel standpoint last year. Number two, you got to have the right quarterback. Is Jamie Newman that? They hope he is. Number three, even if you got all that in place, you got to have the right system in place. So they made a change to the offensive coordinator position. But they lost spring, the most integral time to install, especially new concepts, new systems, new offense, with a new guy under center at quarterback. When you lose all that and you know you got that elite defense coming back, you got to ask yourself, Kirby Smart, very risk-averse in nature. You know who he learned under. Very risk-averse. Is that the kind of guy that's just going to say, oh, so what if we didn't have spring? Man, we had these Zoom meetings. We installed everything over Zoom, and then we got in fall camp, and those 4 weeks told me all I needed to know. Hey, let's just turn it loose offensively. You remember the game they lost last year, South Carolina? You remember what they lost that for? You remember that minus four stat in the turnover category? Guys like him don't forget that. Guys like him look around and say, only way we're losing most of these games is if we take too many risks. So is he all of a sudden going to become a guy that says, I'll turn it loose, man. Caution to the wind. Let's turn it loose. I don't know. I think a lot of people expect one radical or the other, and as usual, probably in between is where we're going to land for Georgia this year.